Hello, I'm a tenant here, and I just have a maintenance issue.
Okay, I can page someone for you. What's your name?
My name is Steve Dave.
What was the last name?
Oh, just Steve Dave. It's all one word, Steve Dave.
Okay, and the phone number?
It's area code 483.
What apartment?
505.
And the problem?
Our toilet's kind of, it's really clogged up because I flushed all of my ex-girlfriend's things down the toilet, and now it won't flush.
Okay, I'll page maintenance for you.
Because I threw, like, everything from her purse in there. I threw some of her dresses and clothes and stuff in there.
Okay, I'll page maintenance for you.
I flushed a 50-pound bag of sand that she
was... Is this a real call?
Of course, why wouldn't it be?
Well, then, why are you telling me all this? I already said I would page maintenance for you.
Well, you asked what the problem was. I'm trying to tell you about my stupid...
Yes, all I needed was toilet clogged. I don't need to know all the things you put in it.
Okay, well, you asked, and I was just telling you. I was telling you you wanted to know about my stupid fucking ex-girlfriend. So I'm just letting you know.
I'm alone, sitting by the telephone. I'm forsworn. I'm texting on my stupid phone. Then I heard my cell phone ring. Roy said that my car was dinged and I was fucking dumb. I really should hang up the phone. I knew he found a way to track us. He was angry and kept yelling.
Hello, everyone. You're listening to the Snowplow Show for June 9th, 2018, but sort of June 8th, 2018, because the live portion of the show was recorded yesterday. I just didn't have time to get it all put together yesterday. I was too busy playing around with Asterix and getting the T&I machine back up and running after about a year and a half of it being down. Back in November of 2016, my Asterix machine was confiscated by the government, and that meant our T&I machine went away. What is the T&I machine, you ask? That's this weird thing I set up in my house that was connected to a bunch of answering machines where you can dial into any of these answering machines and try to hack them. You know, guess at codes and just try and get into them, listen to all the messages, erase the messages, whatever you want to do. Probably listen into my house through the monitor feature. I set up a new Asterix system after that happened, like within a month. I had a new system set up, but I lost all the configuration from the old one, and I just never got around to setting up the machines again. And even after I got my original Asterix computer back, by then I was already into this new system that I had set up. I didn't want to deal with changing it around. Anyway, lots of excuses. I've got it all set up again, and there are now 8 answering machines connected to this thing. And if you want to give it a call and try your luck, the phone number is 505-796-5789. I set them all up in my kitchen this time because the circuits up here in the situation room, they're starting to get a little bit overloaded. I'm running out of watts and amps and stuff, but at least Carol would be proud because, you know, it's in the kitchen. Anyway, the sponsors of today's show are Todd L, B.I. Eber for Life, Brandon R, Kirstie T, Matt Z. Thanks, all of you, for being sponsors of today's show and for supporting the PLA and the Snowplow Show and all the weird shit I do, such as setting up answering machines in 2018. Those 5 people are supporters on the Patreon at patreon.com/phonelosers, and you should be too. Thank you, people who have recently signed up on the Patreon, like Ficon and Grant H, and James L, and Robert W. You guys are the best. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention the T&I. It has a webpage. I just went to it. It's very out of date, but there are some things on there that still apply, such as some of the types of answering machines I've got up there. I'm going to hook up 2 more machines to it. I want a total of 10. That seems like a good place to stop. And I've got the other 2. I just need to get a new phone router. The other 2 are mechanical machines. They've got tapes in them. The webpage for the T&I, though, is phonelosers.com/TNI. That's T as in telephone, N as in network, and I as in interface. I want to get the choose-your-own-adventure thing hooked back up like I used to have. I still have all the old recordings from that, and I'll get that put back up eventually. I want to get the TNI hooked back up how it used to be, but maybe put a lot more stuff on there. I want it to get completely out of control. I'm going to put extensions in every room of my house, including the subterranean levels. All right, anyway, as I was saying before, I did a live show. It was yesterday, and that's what I'm going to play for you right now. Here it is.
He's an ass. He said the only thing that glass. The jackass accidentally killed my grass. I don't give a fuck, he's wise. He said his name was Steve Dave twice. He said we were there giving me those damn snake eyes. He said he tore the roof off of my home. Shut those fucking kids up, you damn road. He was beaming microwaves upon my home. Listen to the snowplow.
Hi everyone, I'm doing a live show. If you're on the Mixler and you hate the Mixler, I've got it set up on the Shoutcast today too. If you want, you know, something that's a little bit lower bandwidth, it's over at phonelosers.com/live, or just click on the thingy in the sidebar. I've been, like, somebody's pranking me, you guys. Somebody has sent a ton of calls to the prank line. It appears that I am selling an apartment, I guess. I haven't listened to any of these. I've just read the transcripts.
Good morning, Roy. My name is Ashton Belcher. I'm currently looking on Craigslist at the nice 3-bedroom, 2-bath home, furnished or not, in New Bedford. I was calling to schedule a walkthrough. So whatever you are.
So I don't know what to say to these people. I'm guessing it's all pretty much the same thing. People looking for an apartment or a house.
Hi,
or something.
Hi, my name's Kelly from your listing, and I was wondering if you could tell me that to schedule a walkthrough.
Hi, hello. My name is Beth 14, and I just saw your ad.
These people all sound like shit.
The house that you were renting. I was hoping that I could maybe schedule something.
So not only do I have a bunch of voicemails, but I'm also getting calls coming in. Here, let me put that window over here on this screen so I don't miss it, because I notice when a call comes in, it doesn't make any noise, so I have to be able to see it. Enable desktop notifications. Okay, I'm going to do that. I'm going to let it do it. Maybe that'll help. But there, yeah, I should be able to see any calls that are coming in. But until then, we can call some of these voicemails, I guess. Tell them that your whole family died in the home and you're done with the place. That's what Nautical wants me to say. Looking for roommates that are into dog fighting.
Hi, good morning, Roy. My name is Elba Torres, and I was calling you about the house that you have for rent for the 3 rooms for $960. Please, can you give me a call back when you got time at 774?
Okay, so I'm going to call her back. Dragon Mirror wants me to say it's haunted. Oh, shit. Okay. I cancel that. Answer this. Hello?
Hi. I guess it's so incredulous you guys have a house for rent.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's me. Got that house for rent.
Okay, so can I go take a look in the house with my wife?
Yeah, yeah. Where are you at?
I'm in Fall River.
Okay. And you know where the house is, right?
New Bedford?
Yeah, that's the one. New Bedford. All the way in, okay. New Bedford. All the way.
Okay, can I have the address?
Hey, do you have a dog, though?
Yes.
How big is it? What's its weight?
It's a lab, so it's not a dangerous dog either.
Ah, shoot. Yeah, I was looking for a bigger dog.
I'm sorry?
I'm looking for a big dog. See, here's the thing. Like, we're really into doing dog fights. So we're looking for someone to move in that wants to do dog fights. Like, make some money on the side doing dog fights.
Yeah. Okay, hold on a sec.
Okay. Honey, can we do dog fights?
Hello?
Hello, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good.
So could you just explain to me what you just said to him? I'm sorry.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Like, we were looking for someone that had kind of a bigger dog, because not only do we want to rent this house, we also want someone that will do dog fights with us.
We want to
fight dogs, like fight to the death.
Okay, this is like a joke or something.
Oh no, I wouldn't kid about this. I'm a Christian. But we got to keep the dog fighting on the DL, you know. Did she hang up? Oh yeah, she hung up. There's no hang up noise. That's weird. It's so weird not to hear a hang up noise. Christian dog fights. That's right. I guess like all of my calls are going to be interrupted by other calls. I've been getting a lot of calls today. And I was going to do a show this morning, but I got obsessed with messing with the asterisk system. I've been setting that thing up again, trying to get the answering machines working so you guys can hack answering machines legally, setting up menus and stuff. Trying to make everything work. So that's why I didn't do a show this morning, because I've been doing all that stuff. Yeah, hopefully they haven't left a message, because if they have, then I'm going to accidentally call them back.
Hi, Roy. My name is Brianna Sampson. I'm calling and I thought
you
could give me a call back early if you need
it. Yeah, I got to get an address also. Right? Like, here, yeah, I'll just look on maps. I need an address all the way in New Bedford. All the way. Ronk wants to sponsor the incoming lines? Okay. Whatever the fuck that means. Let's see. I'm just going to go to a random neighborhood. Click on a house. There we go. 225 Bates Street. Perfect. Let's finish up this mumbling voicemail.
I appreciate it. My phone number is 77. Thank you.
Man, the translation wasn't even close on her phone number. She mumbled so much.
Hello?
Hi, this is Roy. I was returning your call about the house for rent.
Oh, hi, how are you?
Pretty good, how you doing?
Good, thank you.
Who's this?
My name is Brianna.
Oh, hey.
So I was wondering, is it a summer vacation rental or...
Oh, no, it's just a regular house. We were hoping that you might have a dog, though. Do you have a dog?
I actually do.
Oh, how big is it?
It's only 14 pounds.
Oh, that's kind of small. Yeah, we like to do dog fights.
Dog? Oh, yeah, see you later. Bye, piece of shit.
She called me a piece of shit. Man, that really sets people off. What's wrong with a harmless little dog fight, you know? Dragon Mirror says it must be a Boost Mobile neighborhood. That sounds about right.
Hi, Roy. This is Laurie Ann. I'm calling about the apartment you have for rent.
Oh, it's an apartment.
Please, 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 please call me back. I've been searching, and I haven't had any luck. I have registered ESA therapy dog for myself because I have depression, anxiety, and panic attacks.
Okay. No, we're not going to ask her to do dog fights. As hilarious as it sounds.
Hi, Roy. I'm calling regarding the 953 bedroom and two bathroom home in New Bedford. Please call me back if it's still available and when can I come and take a look at it. And what is your requirement? If I don't answer you, just leave me a voicemail.
Ah, man. That's going to leave a voicemail. Come on.
Hello?
Hey, it's Roy. I was returning your call about that apartment for rent.
Yes.
How are you doing?
Hi, Roy.
Hey, pretty good.
Okay, when can I come and take a look at it?
Oh, anytime. We're here. We live like right next door, so that would be convenient. You'd have your landlords right next door. Watching everything you do.
Okay, that's great, but how many people should live there if you want?
How many do you want to live there? We could work something out.
We have 6 people, a father and mother and 4 kids.
4 kids, okay. Do you have a dog?
No.
Oh, do you think you could get a dog?
No, we don't want it.
Yeah, but what if you like went out and bought a dog?
What do you mean?
Well, you know, like... Here's the thing. Me and my wife, we sponsor dog fights in the neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know...
No, it's okay. Like, they don't have any problem with dogs.
Yeah, but, you know, maybe you should get a dog and raise it for a little while and let your kids get attached to it, and then we could, you know, have it do fights in the backyard, because we have your backyard and our backyard all set up for fights. Dog fights.
No, but as far as I know, like, I'm not really interested in dogs, but maybe in the future.
Yeah, I don't know. Like,
you want to rent it to someone who has dogs?
Yeah, someone with big dogs, big mean dogs. Maybe, like, someone that, like, mistreats their dogs.
Okay, no, I'm not interested in dogs. I'm just looking for a partner, that's it.
Would you have? Would you be opposed to having a couple of your kids sleep in the backyard in tents?
Why is that?
Because I'm using one of the bedrooms, like, just to keep some stuff in.
No.
Yeah, I'm just.
No, thank you. No, thank you.
I'm just keeping some papers in there and stuff. That's all.
No. Like, if it's 3-bedroom, I want a 3-bedroom. That's it.
Oh, did you say, is that what you said?
I said, it's the apartment, 3 bedrooms, right?
Yeah, but one of the bedrooms is in use. I've got a bunch of papers in there. I'm just keeping papers in there.
No, like, since it's a 3-bedroom, I want 3 bedrooms.
Yeah, but...
And, like, a family of 6 people live in 2 bedrooms.
Yeah, we didn't say you could use all the bedrooms, and... Instead of one of the bedrooms, you're getting a tent, like a big tent. It's as big as a bedroom in the backyard. It's next to the dog fighting cages.
Yes, but how the kids are under 11 years. How can we
They'll
put
love
them
it.
To sleep in the backyard?
They'll love it. It's like a sleepover. It's like a camp out. It's a camping trip every single night.
No, thank you.
You can put a couple space heaters in the tent. It's totally safe.
Bye.
The dogs will bark if it catches on fire. Man, that was really hard to hear him.
Good afternoon, Roy. My name is Valerie, and I'm calling about the house you have for rent. Roy, if you could please call me back at 508, appreciate it, and I look forward to speaking with you. Thank you, sir. Have a great evening.
All right. Let's call up Valerie about my haunted house with a serious poltergeist problem.
Hello.
Hey, Valerie. This is Roy. I was returning your call about that apartment.
Hi, Roy. How are you? Roy, is it an apartment or a house?
It's a house, but there's just a small area of the back that's been it's converted into apartments, and we live in the backside, and you guys would get most of the house, like the whole front part.
The whole front part. Okay, Roy. Yep. Can you tell me where it's located?
Sure. It's on Bates Street in New Bedford.
Bates.
All the way in New Bedford. All the way.
Bates Street. Okay. Bates
and it has 2 bathrooms, but we're using one of them.
So what do you get? 1 bathroom?
Well, you get 2 bathrooms. You can use the toilet in 1 bathroom, and then you can use the whole bathroom on the other bathroom. It's just we're using the tub. We're manufacturing bath salts.
Oh, okay.
You know, for drug users.
Roy, would I be able to go buy it and see if I think it's big enough for me?
Yeah, sure. That'd be great. I'm here all evening.
Oh, you're going to be there all evening?
Yep.
What number Bates Street is it?
I need to ask, like, are you going to be okay, like... There, we have sort of a poltergeist problem.
Okay, explain that to me.
Well, that's why we live in the backside, because it doesn't seem to bother anything back there. In the main part of the house, though, it will attack. It throws things off of shelves. It'll throw dishes at you. Everyone that moves in, they pretty much just move out within a couple days, usually in the middle of the night.
Are you serious?
Yeah, but I mean, it's cheap though, right?
Okay. That I'd have to discuss with my two children.
But you never know, because sometimes the poltergeist, it takes a liking to some people, but then other people it just totally hates. Like, it actually killed one guy. But it seems to like women...
Someone died in that apartment.
Uh-huh?
Someone died in that apartment.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Like, it has a history. We went to the library and looked it up. It is just, oof. It's got a history. It's an old place.
Really? Okay. Yep. Right, I'm going to have to get back to you with that.
More or less...
Do you mind?
More or less a death in every single room of the house.
Every room in the house. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Are you trying to sell the house?
No, we love it here. It's a good neighborhood, and it's, you know, we got a mortgage and everything.
But you're just having that issue.
Yeah, just the whole poltergeist thing. Have you heard of the Necronomicon?
Yes.
Okay, you know what we're talking about then.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, right, I'm going to have to discuss that with my two children. Do you mind if I get back to you?
Oh, sure, yeah. Yeah, usually the poltergeist loves kids, but they will get possessed. At some point.
Really? Mm-hmm. Okay.
But it doesn't. Right. It doesn't hurt him. It doesn't hurt him. It just controls him.
Just controls. Okay. All right, Roy. I'm going to thank you very much for your time, and I'll get back to you one way or the other.
Okay.
You don't mind?
No. I don't mind at all. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Bye bye.
Bye. Is she really going to talk to her kids about that? Like, okay, kids, listen. I found a good place for us, but you may get possessed. It won't hurt you. It'll just control you. I don't know what the Necromomicon, whatever you said is. Whoever said that. What is that again? Remind me. It's the Book of the Dead from Evil Dead. Oh, yeah. You know, I don't think I've ever seen Evil Dead. It's been on my to-do list for a few years now. Never seen any of the Evil Deads. I'm weird. I've seen Shaun of the Dead, though, so that's the same thing, right?
Hi, I'm interested in the Craigslist posting for the 3-bed, 2-bath in New Bedford.
All the way in New Bedford.
For me, my two parents, and my two children, who are 1 and 2.
Damn. I was hoping he'd say dogs.
We make over $3,700 a month right now.
Oh, okay.
We're willing to pay the first 3 months up front, as well as any, like, the first month, last month, and any security that's needed. Our credit score is a little low right now. We're working on it.
Why would I want you to pay 3 months in advance? Then I couldn't kick you out for 3 months if you sucked.
Other than that, I'd like to hopefully see the apartment if
fuck
possible.
Fuck that shit.
I mean, the place this weekend, if possible, Saturday. Afternoon would be great. Call me back at 774.
Make the bathroom 1-bedroom, 8-bath. It was a typo in the ad. That's what I Regret Jumping says.
Thank you for your time, and have a wonderful weekend.
All right. Nautical disagrees. He says 0 bedrooms, 9 bathrooms. It was a park restroom converted into a house.
Hello.
Hey, it's Roy. I was returning your call about that house.
Yes. Would it be possible for a showing this weekend, sometime after Saturday noon?
Sure, that'd work. Hey, I'm not sure which ad you read, because one of the days it ran as a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom.
Yeah.
But it's actually a, 0-bedroom, 5-bathroom. Craigslist wouldn't let me print it that way, and, like, I think we got it fixed now. There's some confusion on that.
Yeah, so it's no bedrooms?
Right, no bedrooms, but the bathrooms are large, and there's 5 of them.
Oh, okay.
5 and a half, actually, because there's a half bathroom down by the kitchen.
Yeah.
So, like, you can fit beds into the bathrooms. Mm-hmm. But there's no closets. They're just like medicine cabinets.
Oh, okay. I'll talk to my mom about it. Like, so it's just like two large rooms and then there's like some mini ones essentially with,
yeah, there's five bathrooms, no bedrooms.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But you know, there's a nice living room.
Yeah.
Nice normal living room. There's just like every bathroom has a bathtub and a toilet and a sink.
Mm-hmm.
And a scale.
Yeah, I won't be able to take it then. I'm sorry.
Why not?
Because we need like separate rooms for the little ones.
Yeah, but you could sleep in the bathrooms. You could like convert. You could put a mattress on top of the bathtubs, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's what our last tenant did.
Yeah. Thank you, but we're not interested. Thank you, though.
But you can watch TV and poop without needing to leave the room. And the bathroom mirror makes the room look huge. And in the master bathroom, there's like a thing to do your makeup.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yeah.
Hey, can you tell that, sir? Can you tell that kid to shut the fuck up, please?
Mm-hmm. All right. You have a good one. All right. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye. He didn't get mad at all.
Hi, good evening, Roy. My name is Maisha. I'm calling in regards to the 3-bedroom apartment in New Bedford. If that apartment is still available,
all the way.
Give me a call back at 508-7. Thank you so much and have a great day.
Someone with a stupid name says they would never have to wait for the bathroom. Everyone gets their own bathroom.
Hello?
Hey, this is Roy. I was calling about that house. I was returning your call.
Oh, hi, Roy.
Hey, how you doing? Pretty good.
Good. I was actually calling about the house. So that's located in New Bedford?
Yeah, all the way in New Bedford.
I'm in Taunton, so it's not that far from me.
Yeah, but it's all the way.
It's all the way?
Yep.
Oh, all right. So tell me a little bit about the place.
Well, it has 3 kitchens.
3 kitchens?
Yeah, it's eccentric. 3 kitchens, 4 bathrooms, and 0 bedrooms. No living room.
Really? Okay.
It's the darndest thing.
Well, yeah, it sounds like something that I don't think that I might be too.
Okay, listen,
in.
And if you're gonna live here, you can stop flirting with me because I am married, and my wife won't put up with it. So please cut it out.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, sir.
But you know, since you're a woman, there's 3 kitchens.
Yeah, I don't need 3 kitchens, though.
Yeah, well, you know, you could put a bed in one. You don't have to be like that about it.
No, I'm good.
Like,
thank you, though. Thanks for calling.
One of the kitchen is strictly for the meat, if you know what I mean.
Okay, well, thank you. Have a good day.
But you're like, did you want to come look at it?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Like, this is an apartment... A house that you will always know your role in it. Because, like, every room's a kitchen. Get it? Okay, she hung up. I was just reading from the chat room. Like, what the hell were you talking about, Jim Bob? Strictly for the meat? The hell's that mean? I'm not getting a lot of calls anymore. But, you know, it's kind of late over there, all the way in New Bedford. I pulled up this video. If I can find the right place in it. I keep saying all the way in New Bedford because, like, the term New Bedford, the city name, reminds me of this old Neil Cicerega video.
All the
way. Ah, I found it. I found it. Hold on.
I don't let just anybody see my puppets.
But I came all the way from New Bedford, Neil. All the way. All the way from New Bedford, Neil.
I just love that scene. I should put a link to that in the show notes, maybe.
Hi, Roy. This is Anne. My phone number is 5...
I noticed you had an ad up on Craigslist about a 3-bedroom, 2-bath home here in New Bedford. We were wondering if we could come take a look at it sometime very soon.
All the way from New Bedford, Neil.
Call back at 508. Yourself a fantastic day.
New Bedford.
Okay, yeah, so. All the way. Totally not a scammer. Wants me to get their bank info and their social security number. We'll get that rental process started.
Hello?
Hey, this is Roy. I was returning your call about the house.
Ah, yes. Thank you, Roy. I greatly appreciate that. I'm afraid I don't have the add up, but it was, I forget how much it was, but I think it was in New Bedford,
yeah.
And you allowed cats and dogs.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we love cats, especially dogs. Is it a big dog?
He's medium size.
Oh, you'll love the neighbors.
Yeah?
You'll love the neighbors. They do dog fights. The next door neighbors do, like in their backyard.
You mean like pit bull fights?
Oh, well, they do all different sizes and classes of dogs. So if you play your cards right and, you know, you like get to know the neighbors and stuff, you can place some bets on dogs and like even enter your dog into the fights and make enough money to pay your rent. That's what the last lady did.
Yeah, no, we won't be. I know we won't be doing that. Our dog's not a fighter.
Oh well, no, they know how to train them. They know how to train them. They'll like you give your dog to the next door neighbor for like 2 weeks. He'll come out a different dog.
Yeah,
we're gonna
pass on that one.
He'll be a fighter.
He's too old.
Oh no, they'll give him like drugs and steroids and stuff.
Yeah. But anyway, about the house.
Mm-hmm.
So you allow cats, you allow dogs.
Oh, yeah, yeah, every animal possible. You're just going to want to, like, you know, keep an eye on it when it's outside. Don't let the neighbors get to it if you don't, you know, if you're not into that whole thing.
Yeah, definitely not. All righty, well, I'll let my mom know.
Okay.
Some information. How many, it's 3-bedroom?
Yeah, yeah, and there's cameras in every room. We're doing like a real world type thing, like a reality show. So every move you make in the house will be recorded and broadcast live to a website.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, yeah. You'll be famous if you live in this place.
Yeah. Yeah, alrighty. Well, I'll definitely let my mom know. We'll think about it, definitely.
Okay, the cameras don't point at the toilet, just the bathtub, but you can shut the shower curtain so it's not like it's invading your privacy.
Okay, well, that's good to know. Thank you.
And you'll be sharing it with 12 other people in the house?
Okay. So it isn't just like the 3 bedrooms, it isn't just like for one family, you have more families living there.
Yeah, but you can share the bedrooms. Like you can team up, and they might be able to like vote you and your mom out sometimes, you know, if they don't like how you're doing things.
Oh, okay. I get it. I get it. All righty. That's interesting.
Yep, yep. It's a lot of fun. It's not a boring lifestyle, that's for sure.
No, it doesn't sound boring at all.
So I actually work as the producer on the TV show as well, and would you be interested in playing the part of the bitch?
No, that's not me.
Your mom?
Oh, no, you're talking to the wrong people for that one.
Okay.
They're too kind-hearted.
It's fine, though. We need all different types of people in there.
Okay.
And, you know, after a few weeks, who knows?
Yeah. Well, I'll let my mom know, and we'll go from there. We'll contact you if we're interested in it, definitely. So thank you for your information and your time. Greatly appreciated.
Yeah. Are you 15 or something? You talk about your mom a lot.
Oh, I love her. She's my best friend.
I see. Okay. Nothing wrong with that.
No, that's true.
I guess.
Well, you have yourself a great day, all right?
Okay, you too.
I will, thank you.
I love you.
Okay. Bye.
I love you. Say it back. Oh, she went. Her mom's her best friend. Cisco Kid says she's under the control of her mother. Umbilical cord is still connected, says Nautical.
Hi, yes, my name is Ashley. I'm calling about the unit that you have available in New Bedford.
Neil,
it doesn't list
all the way from New Bedford, Neil.
Where exactly it is.
I wanted to make sure that it was still available. And I had a few questions.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's give her a call. Quick, chat room, what am I saying to this lady?
Hello?
Hey, Ashley, it's Roy.
Hi.
Returning your call about the house.
Mm-hmm. How are you this evening?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you for asking. So...
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Sorry, my phone cut out for a second.
Oh, weird.
So, it's obviously still available then, correct?
Yeah. Yep, it's still available.
Okay. And can you remind me which one that is? Because I called on a few different... Yeah.
It's the one, it's got the Indian bathrooms in it, so there's no toilets, okay. There's just like a hole in the floor. And
okay.
And the bathrooms kind of smell because there's no trap, you know, it's just a smelly hole in the floor. You just have to squat over the hole and poop in it. I know it's weird, but it's like traditional.
Oh, and where is that located?
It's all the way in New Bedford. It's over over on Bates Street.
What is it?
225 Bates Street.
Okay. And what were you looking for that one?
$700 a month.
Okay. Would you be able to set up a showing?
Sure. Yeah, we can do that.
Okay. When would you be available?
We're available tonight if you want to come by tonight.
Probably sometime tomorrow.
Possible. That works too. I'll be around. Like, we live just a few houses down, actually. So, you can come by just about any time. I work from home. The thing about the toilets, though, is, there's no plumbing in the house at all. So you're going to need to empty the poop buckets at least weekly. There's like poop buckets under the floor.
Seriously?
Yeah. And, in the kitchen, you've got to like, there's like a weird system of tubes and water jugs and stuff. You have to refill those.
Okay.
We just
me check my schedule and I'll get back.
We encourage people just to go next door and use their hose, because it's like an old lady that lives there and she never notices. You know, that made her hang up. Okay, I blame the chat room for that. Oh, it's 950 Dragonmere? Like, I need to look it up, don't I? I should do that. So I know what I'm talking about.
Hi, Roy. My name is Garth. I'm actually calling regarding your property that you had listed on Craigslist.
Is that actually what you're doing?
I have some tenants right now, and they've been fabulous tenants. And they're just actually looking for a new place because I'm actually going to be selling the house. That they're living in right now.
This is actually a lot.
They said that they called you, and they said that you told them that the house is possessed and that someone has died in every room. I was just wondering if you could call me and confirm that, because it sounds like a pretty wild claim. So again, my name is Garth, and if you could give me a call back
fucking
at
Garth.
508-48.
Who do you think he is?
I really appreciate it. Thank you. Bye.
Oh man, I got something to say to Garth. Oh wait a minute, it's the wrong. He gave me a number that's not the number he called from. Okay, hold on, I got to replay it. Hopefully, with you guys not hearing it. Okay, here we go. Yeah, I got the ad pulled up. Thank you for sending that to me. Whoever did that. Thanks for posting in the chat room so everyone can call me now.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice.
Fucking Garth, I'm gonna call him from the number that he called from. I don't have to follow Garth's rules. Calls me a liar and tells me what number to call. I regret jumping. Says it's next.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice.
It's next to an airport, so the ghosts are always getting shredded.
Hi, how are you? My name is Tiffany, and I was calling about the apartment.
Did she ask the voicemail how the voicemail was doing?
If you will. Just
the hell, Tiffany.
Call back at 777. I'm sorry. My name is Tiffany again.
Hello.
Hi, is this Roy?
Yeah, hey.
Hey, Roy, this is Garth. Did you get my message?
Yeah, I did. The one where you called me a liar?
I did not call you a liar. I just said that that's
did.
What they were claiming.
Yeah, and it's true. And what you think you want to come and get like a tour and see a poltergeist? You're not going to like what you find.
I guess this is some kind of gag, and you like throwing stuff up on Craigslist for fun.
It's not a gag. The poltergeist will throw you through the fucking wall.
Okay, so you're a whackball. All right, have a good day.
You're a whackball. Fucking Garth. At least my name isn't Garth. Take that, Garth. All right, let's call Tiffany. He's like running to Craigslist right now so he can report that ad. Get it taken down. Totally something Garth would do.
Hello?
Hey, Tiffany?
Yes, how are you?
Pretty good. It's Roy. You called about my house that I'm renting?
Yes. I was interested in it.
Okay. You know it's right by the airport, all the way in New Bedford, right?
Actually, no, I had no idea. I'm familiar with, like, so far by Brooklawn Park.
Oh.
And things like that. I'm not fully all the way around familiar with New Bedford unless I'm going where I need to be, which is point A to point B.
I see. Yeah. Yeah, it's just a small airport.
Okay. Yeah. What would you actually be looking for or needing? Is it first and last, or are you looking for security too, or?
Oh, yeah, just first, just the first month's rent and then the security deposit. We don't have to do last month's rent.
Awesome.
But...
Okay, are you the owner?
Yeah, yep, me and my wife, we own the house.
Okay, is there a possible way we could possibly come see the house sometime tomorrow, like after, like, 1-2-ish when my boyfriend gets off of work?
Yeah, anytime is good with us. We live just a few houses down, so any time of the day is good with us. Hey, would you have a problem with a large pit in the living room?
Nope.
Okay, because it pretty much takes up the entire living room. Like, you could put a couch in there, but if you stand up, if you get off of the couch, you're going to fall into the pit. Like, we've been digging a tunnel underneath the house, like a series of intricate network of tunnels, basically.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, like a bunker. And we're going to cover it up eventually, but right now we need the pit open so we can haul dirt out of it 24/7.
Well, I'm pretty sure, I mean, my boyfriend's really good in helping out if you guys need help with that, if we do decide to take the place and whatnot, have you. I'm in a situation where I have to move out immediately because I stay with my boyfriend, and his mom, you know, is old school and traditional, and she's not okay with me being there anymore at this point in time and
what
moment
a bitch.
Due to certain circumstances. So right now, because I'm actually brand new, I'm originally from New Jersey. I'm just giving you a short background because everybody wants to have references about, you know, landlords and stuff like that. I'm newly from New Jersey, and I've been out here for only 2 years. The last person I stayed with was my ex-baby father. Well, my ex-boyfriend, which is my baby father. And we split up a ways ago before, you know, I ended up with my new boyfriend.
Okay, yeah. Sounds like...
So I'm trying to step out in my own ring. I have a 2-year-old little girl. So, you know, it's just going to be about us. But it's mostly just going to be me and my daughter.
You're going to want to keep...
Because he travels a lot.
You're going to want to keep the little girl away from the living room because there's a pit and we don't have any safety rails or anything around it.
Oh, I could get a gate for that.
Oh, no. This pit, it covers... It goes around the entire living room and there's just like a rope. We've got a rope stretched across and then a rope that you hold onto with your hand. You just kind of have to shimmy along the rope to get from the front door to the kitchen.
Okay, do you know how long it would be before you can cover that pit up?
Probably just 3 years, because, you know, we're digging it really deep.
And okay.
That's the only entrance we have right now. Then after that, there's just going to be a hatch, and we'll just be, you know, we'll be coming up through it every once in a while to come out for supplies.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's take a look at it and see how bad it is.
Okay.
Let's see what's going on.
Well, it's not bad. I'm not saying it's bad.
If it's not that bad and it's something that I'm able to keep, which I'm sure I'm going to be able to keep my daughter from because she's not really all over the place like that.
Yeah. We can't have
gates.
And
right now she's like I said, right now it's in the safety of just all of us, you know, just all of us and get off, you know, his mom's back.
Yeah. You can let her like play around on the couches and stuff. But like if she falls off the couch, she'll fall into the pit and it's like 40 feet deep.
Holy Lord have mercy.
Yeah,
oh,
it's 40 feet deep. There's like two levels to it.
Okay.
So, you know, she might land on, you know, some of the scaffolding that's down there.
Yeah, I'd rather not think about that like that.
But yeah, yeah, she
like that. But I'd rather look at it first, okay. And let's see what happens.
And there's this homeless man that lives down there. Like, he got in, and we can't get him out.
Oh Lord!
Like, he just kind of runs around in there, and we get rid of him. We're like, shoo. And he comes back. Like, I think he's got like a secret entrance in from some other place.
Like, oh,
I
wow.
I think we ran into like a homeless camp tunnel at some point when we were digging through all these tunnels. And he says he has squatter's rights. It's the darndest thing. Like, he gets mail.
Well, he only has that right until you close it up, right?
Yeah, but you know, we're gonna like the latch is gonna be on the inside, so he'll be able to just like open up the hatch in the living room. Which is basically the entire living room floor, and just come out whenever he wants. Like, go make him a sandwich. He keeps coming up and taking food. Oh, I mean, he seems harmless enough. Like, he's not going to hurt anyone.
Okay. Well, I will definitely be giving you a call.
His name's Desmond.
Can I have your name again? You said Roy, right?
Yeah, Roy. R-O-Y.
All right, Roy, you will be hearing from me tomorrow. I'll call you probably like around 12:30 once confirmed.
Okay.
And if you guys are available, we'll definitely come through to take a look at the police.
All right. And like, would you and your daughter have any problem like enlisting in this subterranean war that we're in the middle of fighting?
War? What do you mean war?
Well, nobody's died yet, but it's stuff's starting to get pretty, things are heating up. It's like a Cold War at this point, and we just don't know what's going to happen. It's a mess. We've run into the pit went down far enough that we've run into other civilizations.
Oh.
So and okay. they're not happy about the they're calling it an invasion, and it's not really an invasion because we own the property, so obviously we own all the land underneath.
Exactly.
But they disagree. They say they've been down there for centuries.
Wow.
So
from what I'm hearing, it doesn't necessarily, as far as the only thing that, you know, helps, like, puts a bit of concern is the pit. I'd rather see how big and how bad it is and what I can and cannot control, because that would be the ultimate choice that would help me make the choice in between staying there, coming, or going.
Oh, I see, yeah. It's as big
back
as...
and forth war thing. Again, I don't know how deep that runs or how big the issue is, but I guess we'll find out once we see.
It's about as big as the skeleton chamber in the Goonies, but remember there was that ledge around the edge, like around the skeleton piano?
Yep.
And they could like shimmy around the edges of it to get over to the door. It's kind of like that.
Like that. Okay. Hmm.
But yeah, the hole we dug only goes down 40 feet, but then after that, it goes down into like the stuff that was already there, it goes down another 100 or 200 feet.
Okay.
But you know, just tell your daughter no.
Okay.
Stay away from the edge. She'll learn.
Okay.
She'll only fall once, you know? That's what they say.
And that's all we need is one time and something that I can't afford. So, but like I said, let's.
Sure, that's how they learn.
Call.
That's how they learn.
Right. Amen. Amen for that.
Yep.
But I'll definitely give you a call, Roy. Like I said, if you are available after 1 o'clock, because I have to wait till my boyfriend gets off of work, that would be pretty. That'll work out pretty good for me.
Okay, great. Yeah, anytime. Just give me a call or stop by or whatever.
Thank you, Roy. You have a good day.
Bye, Tiffany.
Bye.
Man, she must really be desperate for a place to live. She's considering joining the revolution. I should have warned her that what was it called? The sewer people? Somebody in the chat room said the sewer people. They may ask her to, like, you know, they may trick her into switching sides. She may find herself on one side of the war and then her daughter on the other side. They'll be enemies. You'll be, like, shooting machine guns at your daughter. And somebody in the chat room said that, like, she actually understood when I mentioned the Goonies the what was it called? The skeleton chamber? I don't know, the piano room? She knew what I was talking about. I painted a visual for her. It's in a crappy old movie.
Hi, Roy. This is Patty. I am calling in regards to your ad on Craigslist. Mm-hmm. If you could call me back, I'd like to know the location and if it's still available.
But I came all the way from New Bedford,
go quickly.
Neil. All the way.
508.
All the way from New Bedford, Neil.
If I don't answer, could you at least leave me the address, please, and I'll get back to you? Thank you.
Just
have a nice
show
day.
Up?
Bye-bye.
Give her the address, whatever. Okay, before I call this one, what am I saying, chat room? More subterranean wars? Someone said no electricity, just candles. The floor's dirt. Very traditional. All right, let's go with that. Whale oil lamps. Ah, fucking Patty. She's not picking up.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
I regret jumping says the house is currently on fire.
Hi, Roy. My name is Bernadette, and I'm calling about the posting you have on Craigslist. My number with area code 401.
Oh, she's an outsider.
And again, I'm calling about the posting on Craigslist. If you can call me back, I would really appreciate it. Thank you.
Two of the bedrooms are not on fire.
Hello.
Hey, Bernadette.
Yes.
This is Roy. I'm returning your call about that apartment house machine.
Which one?
It's the one all the way in New Bedford. The three
the
bedroom.
One in New Bedford?
Yeah, three bedroom, two bedrooms. 19th century dirt floors.
The one in New Bedford. Okay.
All the way in New Bedford.
All the way in New Bedford. All right, hold on.
Hi, this is John.
Oh, hey, John.
Oh, sorry, you just caught us here. We're just finishing up the dinner.
I see. What you having?
I definitely want to get your call.
What are you eating?
I had the fish and chips at the Governor Francis restaurant.
Oh, okay. Gross.
Oh, it's excellent. Yeah.
I guess.
So, you guys have a place over in New Bedford. That's across the bridge.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Right?
All the way. Yep.
Okay.
All the way in New Bedford.
I saw some pictures online. So, is it possible you could send, I don't know if it had an exterior picture, though.
Oh, yeah. Well, like, it's a Victorian home.
Can you send a couple just through here on the phone?
Oh, I don't have a cell phone. I can do it through email or something.
Oh, yeah, email.
Yeah.
To me, my first name is John, if you had a pen and paper.
Yeah, yeah. Are you okay with dirt floors? Like, you saw that it had dirt floors, right?
No, it has dirt floors.
Yeah,
no,
like, every room in the house has dirt floors. It's very traditional.
Is this an irk?
An irk?
The oblong house. What type is this one?
Oh yeah, it's kind of oblong. It's a Victorian. There's no plumbing or electricity.
Okay.
So like I know there was lights in the pictures, but those are just kind of a farce. Like they're battery powered lights.
I have to pull that up and look at it one more time.
Yeah, those are just from the previous tenant. They had battery powered lights in there. They're not very traditional people. We kicked them out because they weren't very traditional.
All right. Let me get out of here and call you back then. Instead of I'm talking to Laura, these other people.
Okay.
I was in the restaurant. I'll get out of here in the next 10, 15 minutes. Call you right back.
Okay. It'll probably be rented by then, but okay. Sounds great.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Yeah, I know. He's still thinking maybe. I gotta remember Bernadette is the dirt floor lady.
Hi, my name is Tina Marie. I'm just calling about the three bedrooms.
Why does everyone sound like shit?
I was wondering if you accept Section 8, if it is for rent and not rent to own, and if you accept Section 8 social housing.
Sure, why not?
If you do, please give me a call back. My number's 508.
Hell yeah, Section 8. Why wouldn't we? Dexter says Section 9 only. The house is haunted and replays the Civil War battle that occurred on the land.
Hello?
Hey there, it's Roy. I'm returning your call about that house apartment.
Yes.
And are you still interested in that?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, we take Section 8 and all that.
Okay, which apartment is this one for?
It's a 3-bedroom, 2-bath.
Okay, this is the house?
It's got a kitchen, yeah.
Okay, yeah, great, and you do accept Section 8?
Oh, yeah, yep.
Oh, wonderful.
I can't remember if I put this in the ad, but the house is currently on fire.
Oh, no. I don't. What do you mean on fire?
Just part of it. So like originally it was 6 bedrooms, but right now it's down to 3. It's been on fire for a while now.
Oh, okay. But is it livable?
Oh yeah, yeah. You want to stay out of the attic because there's a lot of smoke and fire. And then there's this room behind the kitchen. It's on fire. It was like a spare bedroom and an extra bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
But like currently, it's 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms. And they're all in good condition. There's a bit of smoke damage, and probably your furniture might get a little bit of smoke damage.
Mm-hmm.
But if they ever get the fire out, it'll stop.
Oh, I'm not sure. I'm not sure if Section 8 would accept that. That's.
Oh no! We've done Section 8 forever. Like as long as I've owned it. Do you have like little?
Really?
Do you have little kids?
No, he's 12.
Okay, then he knows to stay away from the fire, then, right?
Of course. Yeah.
Because it's just part of the house.
Oh, okay.
It's on fire.
So it is Section 8 acceptable then?
Yep. As long as you're okay with fire, because a lot of people come in here and they're just surprised.
Mm-hmm.
That it's currently on fire. And we're
you kind of scare me when you say it like that. Part of it pot on fire.
No, it's
it was like a 6-bedroom.
It's currently on fire. It's currently on fire.
It's currently on fire.
Yeah, we've got warning signs up and caution tape. But on the upside, you don't have to run the heat. I mean, it's not that great in the summer, but in the winter, it's kind of nice because you don't have to run the heat.
Okay. Where is this located?
It's all the way over in New Bedford. On
it's currently on
Bates Street, yeah.
On what street?
Bates Street.
Bates Street.
Yeah.
Is there a way to see the apartment, to see it first?
Yeah, yep. You can definitely, we live just a few houses down. You're going to want to park your car around the block, though, and just kind of walk over because there's fire trucks out front. They're blocking the driveway.
You mean it's currently on fire right now?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Wow.
Yeah, it's cool.
Really?
It's cool. Oh, it's cool though. Like it's fine. It's been like this forever now.
Okay. Well, we can take a look at it.
Yeah, I mean the good thing is that it's safe because there's firemen there 24/7. So, you know, if anything ever goes wrong, you've always got a fireman standing by. You know? Ma'am, hello?
Hello?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm still here.
Can you please repeat that?
No, I was saying it's like, it's kind of nice because there's always a fireman standing by. Like, there's, you know, they're always there 24/7.
So it's going to be a joke. Oh, so there's firemen across the street or something?
No.
It has to be a joke. There's no way.
What's she talking about? Who is that?
Who would rent something that's currently on fire? I don't
Am I being rude?
No, I think it's a joke.
This is not a joke, right?
No, it's not a joke. I don't know what her problem is. Like, maybe she's the fucking joke. We don't need that kind of negativity around here. What's her problem? Jeez.
After the address,
what's the address?
The address. It's not. It's 225 Bates Street, all the way over in New Bedford.
Bates Street.
Yeah, B A T E S.
Hold on just a second.
And what's she yelling about in the background, though? I mean, come on, it's Section 8. What's she expect?
Excuse me?
I said, what's she yelling about in the background? It's Section 8.
What is she... don't mind her. Yeah. Don't mind her.
Yeah, you should tell her to shut the fuck up. What's she saying?
Number is what?
Are you asking me again?
Yeah.
Oh, you should have wrote it down the first time. It's 225 Bates Street.
B-A-T-E, you said?
Yeah, but B-A-T-E-S. Hey, are you going to have a problem, are either of you going to have a problem with a transgendered fire crew?
Transgender fire crew?
Yeah, I'm just asking because the last people, they had a problem with that.
I'm telling you, this is a joke. It's a joke.
It's not a joke. Tell her to shut the fuck up.
It's a joke.
It's not a joke.
They're joking. It has to be a joke. This is it real.
Tell her her face is a joke.
Your face is a joke, supposedly.
This guy's calling me that the two-bedroom house with two baths is, three-bedroom house with two baths.
So she thinks transgendered people are a joke?
What? No, I'm talking about this fire thing.
Okay, because she seemed fine with it until I mentioned the transgendered firemen, and then all of a sudden she's saying it's a joke. Like she's afraid of transgender people.
Oh, it has
people.
Nothing to do with transgender.
Well, it seems like it does. It seems like as soon as I mentioned transgendered, your whole tone changed.
Oh, when you said transgender.
Yeah, it's like you hate transgendered people. You're a homophobic... hate monger type person.
No, we're not transgender phobic or any of that.
Seems like you are.
Apologize, Chichi. He didn't like the way you said transgender.
What does it mean?
Chichi, you was telling us transgender fire men or something like that.
No, it was you.
And he said he didn't like the way you said it.
No, it wasn't her. Oh. It wasn't Chichi. It was the bitch in the background that keeps talking over everyone.
How the heck do I know that y'all talking about? It's a joke. He's a joke. I don't know who he is. He's a joke. He's trying to say the house is currently on fire.
Why is the uncle feeling on fire?
Really? And he says that Section 8 will still let it go through. I'm like, no, the hell they won't.
Hey, why don't you change the battery in your fire in your smoke alarm?
I know. Like that. Seriously. Like who wants to get a place that's currently on fire and has smoke damage and stuff like that? Like, who in their right mind wants a place like that? Be for real.
Well, you know, like other people have lived there when it's been like that and they haven't had a problem with it. They just moved out because the husband got a job in California. That's all. Oh, she hung up. I loved how it took him a while to figure that out, though. That was great. The whole fire thing.
Your home for the PLA, the Mr. Bates Radio Show.
And umbrellas.
One second. My headset just came apart.
CatTieRadio.com.
It's getting late, you guys. I'm going to have to quit. Got tons of numbers in here still, though. Let's see if my ad's been reported yet. Nope, it's still there.
Hi, Roy. This is Patty.
Oh, wait. I already tried Patty. She didn't pick up. Oh, this is the lady that just grunted at me. Not that one. How about this one?
Hi, Roy. My name is Tracy. I was calling about the three-bedroom home you have for rent in New Bedford. My boyfriend and I are currently trying to get custody of three of my grandchildren from Virginia.
Jesus.
You'll notice that this is a Virginia number, but we currently live in Carver, but we really
all
need
the way.
A bedroom home.
All the way from New
call
Bedford,
us back
Neil.
So we can schedule a walkthrough. 540. Thank you very much. Bye.
A lot of drama. People trying to bring their drama into my house, into my rental. How many kids did she say? Three of my grandchildren from Virginia. What am I doing on this one? How about dirt floors? Unless you guys in the chat room say something different. It's going to be dirt floors. That's what we're doing. Dexter wants me to ask if her children are deadbeat parents. I'm sure that'd go over well. Why not?
Hello?
Hey there. This is Roy. I was returning your call about the apartment house.
Yes.
Were you still interested in that?
Yes, we are. Yeah, we're in the process of trying to get custody of three of my grandchildren. They're in foster care in Virginia.
Okay.
So we need a three-bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yep,
yeah.
It's a nice place.
I noticed
it's very...
the rent is $950 a month, right?
Yep, that's it. It's a very traditional place. I don't know if you noticed, but the floors are all dirt.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, all the floors are dirt. The stairs are dirt.
Oh, really?
Yep. So you have to take off your shoes. There's no plumbing or electricity. No, it's all very traditional. There's like two outhouses in back, though. Like two full outhouses.
That wouldn't work for us then, because they wouldn't approve that.
Why wouldn't they approve it? It's just a traditional house. It's just a different lifestyle. It's nothing wrong with it.
Oh, really?
Yep.
All right. Well, we'd be willing to come out and take a look.
Okay. For some reason, you know the theme to Jumanji, the drums that beat?
Uh-huh.
It plays 24/7 at low volume, even though there's no electricity in the house. We don't know where it's coming from, but it's just like the drums.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it just plays all the time. We don't know what that's about.
Hmm. All right. Can we come out tomorrow afternoon?
Yeah, that'd be great. Like, anytime you want, really. We live just a few houses down, so we could show it
all
anytime.
Right. Could you text me the address?
Sure, I can do that. And are you okay?
Right.
Like, there's a stream going through the house, flowing through it?
A stream flowing through the house?
Yeah, fresh water.
That's different.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
okay.
It goes all the way through it, like from like the front right side of it all the way into the back.
Mm-hmm.
There's a...
Oh, really?
It just flows away into the backyard.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yep. And then that's where that's what the poo water flows into.
Oh, okay. Yeah, if you could text me the address, we'll come by tomorrow afternoon. We get off around 12 tomorrow.
Okay, yeah, that sounds great. And you'd be
splitting
up the rent.
Just text it to this number, okay?
Okay, yeah. And you'd be splitting up the rent, by the way, with the Section 8 caller.
I'd be splitting up the rent with a Section 8 caller?
Yeah, it's a new thing we're doing. Don't worry about it. But yeah, I'll text you the address.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Hey, are you allergic to DDT?
To DDT, no.
Okay, just making sure. No reason.
Okay, all right. Bye.
Did you tell me when you get off?
We get off at 12.
Okay, that's TMI, all right? Look, I'm not looking to know personal information about you. Just come on. Have some tact. TMI.
Okay.
Ugh.
All right, thank you.
Are you okay with a collection of ticks in the house? Oh, she's gone. Was that you with the Jumanji reference, Cisco Kid? Maybe the next call should be nothing but Jumanji.
Hi, how you doing? This is Mariella.
It's a voicemail.
I'm calling you regarding the apartment.
I can't answer you back.
Can you please give me a call as soon as possible? I'm interested in it. So
you're asking questions to a voicemail.
Hello?
Hey, is this Mary?
Yeah, this is Mariella.
Hey, Mariella, it's Roy. You called about my house that's for rent?
Yeah.
Were you still interested in that?
Yeah, which one it is, because I really sent like two or three.
Oh, okay. It's a three-bedroom, two-bathroom, and it has the Jumanji drums in the background.
Where is located at?
It's all the way in New Bedford.
I'm in New Bedford.
Yeah, but it's all the way in New Bedford.
Yeah, okay. It's still available, though?
Oh, yeah, it's definitely available. There's a few small issues with it. There's this, have you ever seen the movie Jumanji?
No.
I don't know.
Well, what's it going on?
Well, it's just that there's these African bats in the chimney, and then there's these giant spiders that are, like, bigger than humans. Or wait, no, I wouldn't say that. They're about the size of a dog. These spiders that are about the size of dogs. Like in the attic, and we can't get rid of them.
Wow.
Yep, they've been there since the 60s.
You serious?
Yep, I'm completely serious. And for the most part, they're pretty harmless.
And then what's the pet control?
They you can't get rid of them. Like, we've tried, and it just doesn't do any good. They just keep coming back. So there's spiders that are the size of dogs. There's African bats in the chimney. There's these weird mosquitoes that are like oversized mosquitoes. Like they're big enough. Like they.
And you're renting that place.
Yeah, because it doesn't hurt anyone. It's just, you know, there's just a lot of stuff like that going on with the house. Have you ever seen Beetlejuice?
Excuse me?
Have you ever seen the movie Beetlejuice?
Yes.
Okay. Then you know what I'm talking about. Yep.
And you're renting that place.
Yeah, we're renting it.
Oh.
Look, I'm just going to have to hang up on you if you're not going to take this seriously. Because I only have, like, maybe 20 minutes tops of show left.
Okay, well, place like that, I don't want to rent one place like that.
Well, you know what? I don't want to rent to you anyway.
Okay.
Take that.
All right, thank you.
If you're going to be like that about it, take that.
Okay.
Good.
I'll take it.
Good. Hang up.
Thank you.
Hang up then.
Okay.
We need someone that's seen the movie.
Hi, Roy. This is Carly Williams.
Carly's seen the movie.
I'm just calling to inquire about your property in New Bedford. Mm-hmm. I will be moving to Cohasset. Well, I'm not.
But I came all the way from New Bedford, Neil.
And I am here right
all
now.
All the way.
I'm working at the soccer
all the way
complex
from New Bedford,
Cohasset,
Neil.
We're just trying to find some options of good places to live, and I was really interested in your home. I do realize it's about an hour away.
Yeah, okay. She talks too much. She has an Indiana area code. That's weird. She probably explained that. I wasn't listening. It's not my home. It's my neighbor's house.
Hi, this is Carly.
House.
Sorry I missed your call.
Carly. Okay, whatever. I don't want to rent to an outsider anyway.
Hi, Roy. My name is Marie. I'm calling about the three-bedroom rental that you have available. I'm very interested. If you could give me a call back at your... My number is 508. Again, it's Marie.
That's
5. Hello?
Hey, Marie.
This is she.
Oh, hey, it's Roy. I'm returning your call about the apartment house.
Yes, definitely.
And yep. Were you still looking for something?
I am. Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Yeah, this is still available. We're just kind of showing it to people and taking applications.
Okay. When are you going to be selling it?
Anytime you want. We live just a block away. My wife and I do. So we can show up pretty much anytime. We're both here. There's one of us here pretty much all the time.
Wonderful. What do your Saturdays look like? Do you think, like, I know it's kind of like, you know, the weekends kind of keep to yourself. Most people do.
Not us. But yeah, it's over on Bates Street. Did you read the ad?
I did read it. I've read so many, though. You'll have to just refresh my memory just a little bit.
So I did read that it is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath. You allow pets. And it was $950.
Did you read the ad that mentioned the African bats?
The what?
African bats.
Bats?
Yeah, bats, like in the chimney.
Oh, no, I didn't read that.
Okay,
no.
Yeah, they'll come out of the fireplace sometimes. There's African bats in the fireplace.
Well, but that's pretty interesting.
Yeah, they don't, like, bite or anything. They just kind of chase you around a little bit.
I mean, that's kind of when you have a fireplace and you have a house, there are things that come along with it.
yeah, it happens.
Mm-hmm.
But it's there's a lot of small issues like that. If you can, we can show you when you come by to look at it. But there's a weird thing with spiders in the attic too.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, if you're available, I mean, I could come around maybe one-ish.
Yeah, we could do that.
Okay, and what number is it?
Which phone? Oh, on Bates Street, it's 225.
225, okay.
Yeah, all the way in New
Bedford.
Very
good. What is your application process, just so I know ahead of time?
It's just an application. You don't have to pay for a credit check or application fee or anything until after we've gone over it and approved things and just checked references.
Okay. And are you looking for first-class security?
Just first month and security deposit, which is the same as the
wonderful.
First month. And the entire living room is actually a liquor store. Like it's a part business, part home.
Okay.
So the liquor store is open until 8 p.m. and you'd be responsible for running that.
You're kidding me, right?
No. It's not disconnected from the house at all. So it's like in the living room, there's the liquor store, but you can just go right into the kitchen.
I've never heard of anything like that in my life.
Yeah, it's kind of grandfathered in. It's not supposed to be zoned for business here, but we've had the liquor store for so long.
That doesn't really sound like something I'd be interested in running a liquor store when I'm in my living room. But
yeah, well, it's not a busy liquor store. It's not like we advertise it or anything, but it's... like we can't get rid of it. It's grandfathered in. It's like under a lease type thing for the next 12 more years.
What is the name of it?
The liquor store?
Yes.
The name of the liquor store or the name of the neighborhood?
The name of the liquor store.
Does it have to have a name?
Okay, like, I think this is kind of funny. All right, I'm going to let you go, but thank you for calling me back.
We don't ever advertise the liquor store.
Yeah.
But
well, good luck renting it. I mean, that doesn't sound like something I'm interested in.
Well, why not? Like, it's not that hard to run a liquor store that doesn't get that much business. You just have to answer the door every once in a while. I mean, people just walk in and you have to take care of them and they leave.
Yeah, I have a full-time job and a child. I don't think that's something that, fits into my life. But
how old's the child?
Yeah. My child's 12.
Oh, see? Yeah. It's fine because it's like the whole, having to be 18 to run a liquor store doesn't matter because it's your home. So he could, like, man the register. It'd be, like, a responsibility, like an after-school job for him.
So a what?
It'd be like an after-school job for your kid. Show them responsibility.
Yeah, so would that pay for my rent? Is that what you're saying? Well, is it like rent-free and like you run the store?
No, you'd get paid. You can use your paycheck for the rent if you want. I didn't want to mention the name of the liquor store because it's kind of obscene, but it's called Dick Liquor.
Yeah, and I guess so.
It's like written on the front of the house. So if that's something that's okay with you, then... Oh, she hung up. She hung right up when I said Dick Liquor. I couldn't think of any of the obscene liquor store names, and somebody in the chat room reminded me. Thank you, chat room. Someone else was saying that there is a garage sale in the garage all the time, I think. I don't know. I think we're going to do 13 more minutes. And at exactly 5 o'clock, I'm out of here. Backdoor liquor basket. I kind of want to call Garth back.
Hi, Roy. This is Tania. I'm looking at the 3-bedroom on Craigslist for $950 a month. Can you please contact me at 508?
Sounds like she's reading. I should do a late night show tonight. Call these people up at like 2 in the morning. Johnny Lemon wants me to say that there's an ISIS training facility next door.
Call has been forwarded to an automatic voice.
Liz says we have to drive her there blindfolded. That's gotta happen.
Hi, this is Beth. I just came across your ad on Craigslist about the three-bedroom house for rent.
Yeah.
If you can give me a call back, my name is Beth, and my telephone number is 508.
Molecular Heckler says it has no doors. You have to climb through a window. Everything in the house is designed for small people.
Hi, it's Amy. I can't get to the phone right now, but leave me a message, and I'll get back.
I just refreshed the posting. And it says this posting has been flagged for removal. I wonder why.
Hi, Roy. My name is Mercedes. I found your ad on Craigslist for the 3-bed, 2-bath home that you have available for rent, and I would like to schedule a time to come and see it, if possible. I am from Colorado, but I am currently in Massachusetts for secure housing, and I'll be available until Tuesday. So if you have any time between today and Tuesday to show the home, I would definitely love to get a chance to come out and see it. If you could just give me a call back at your earliest convenience. My phone number here is
7-
Hi, this is Roy. I'm returning your call about that house.
Oh, hello.
Hello. Were you still interested in that?
Yeah, I just wanted to set up a time.
Okay, yeah, we can do that. What time? What day is good for you? We're pretty open this week.
I am here until Tuesday, so really any day before Tuesday.
Oh, okay. Like tonight or tomorrow or?
Whichever I can do tonight or tomorrow.
Okay. Do you know where the seaport?
Is there a time that works better for you?
Do you know where the Seaport Inn is in New Bedford?
No, but I'm sure I can find it.
Okay. Yeah. What we usually do is we have people meet us there, and then we would blindfold you and drive you to the house.
That's mildly concerning.
Why is that?
Why would you blindfold someone to take them to a house?
Oh, it's don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. It's just something we do. And once you pay the security deposit in the first month, then we'll talk about letting you know where it's located. But you know, it's just you can't be too careful these days with people on the internet, especially from out of town.
Yeah, I guess that's fair, but I kind of feel like the reverse is also true, so.
Well, that's somebody that you'd have to be worried about. That's something they would say. Is it just going to be you, or are you going to bring someone with you?
No, it would just be me.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't be the only one living there, but.
Okay, well, see, it's fine then, because it's just me. I'll be the one picking you up. I'm blindfolding you and leading you into the house. And once you're in the house, you're welcome to take the blindfold off.
Okay.
So, yep.
Yeah, no, that sounds like a kidnapping, so.
Oh, no, it's not a kidnapping. We just don't want people to know where it is.
I'm pretty sure that is actually the literal definition of a kidnapping, is if you take someone against their will, the aspiration.
It's not against your will.
Element
it's
of
like
that.
We're just showing you a house.
It kind of is.
Why are you being such a weirdo? Why are you being so sketchy about this?
Because you're trying to blindfold me and take me to a strange house?
No, I'm not I'm letting you know ahead of time. Like, if I were a kidnapper, I would be, like, not telling you about this.
Uh-huh.
Durr. Don't you know how things work?
Yes, because I have looked at several houses here now, so I can't say I've had to be blindfolded for any of them at this point.
Yeah, well, they were probably crappy houses then.
No, they were actually quite nice.
That's why you're still looking.
I sure am.
Anyway, before you hang up on me and call the police, I need to let you know something.
Hey, Lamo! You just got full-on butt-slammed by the Skippy and Dippy Morning Show on 100.9 The Gerbil. Don't let it get you down. Slamming is what we do best. To hear your call and to hear yourself get totally slammed, tune in every weekday morning at 8:30 and 10:30 to hear the Daily Butt Slam. After this pre-recorded message, you'll be transferred to one of our jockeys, who will get your permission to air your slam. If we don't get your permission, we'll air it anyway, because we're totally wacky. Tune in every weekday.
Hello, this is Carol. I'm the producer. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. How you doing?
Well, I guess. How are you?
Oh, pretty good. I just needed to get your permission. We're going to put that call on the radio tomorrow morning.
Cool. So what station is that so I can listen to it?
That's WBGZ 1570 AM.
Really?
Yep.
I didn't even know people still listen to AM.
Oh, hey, fuck you, lady. You know, fuck you. We don't have to take that from you. Who do you think you are?
You really don't, and yet you're still talking to me, so...
Fancy pants from Colorado. FM radio listening piece of garbage. Whatever.
No, still don't listen to AM.
No, that means you listen to just crappy, shitty stuff then. Bye.
Okay, bye.
All right. I think I averted the crisis of having her call the police. Yeah, what the hell, Liz? Trying to get me in trouble? Telling me to, like, blindfold people and take them to houses? Jeez. Fucking Liz. Just can't trust her. Oh, here's a couple more. Okay, like, really, I gotta get going, you guys. Let's just try, like, one or two more. Or I've got three here that have not... Oh, wait, shit, there's more than that even. Man, there's a lot of people. But here's one from 8:50 this morning.
Hi, Roy. My name's Ralph. Interested in the rental you have in New Bedford. Wondering if it's possible to schedule a time to see it. Maybe on Tuesday next week. I'm down in the Cape. Actually here for the month of June.
Down in the Cape. Did I call Ralph already? I don't think I called Ralph. Ah, shit. Okay, forget Ralph. I'm going to pick this up. Hello?
Yes, hello. I just missed a call from this number.
Oh, yeah, it's Roy. You were calling about that.
Oh, hi. I thought maybe it was you.
Yep.
How you doing?
Oh, pretty good. How you doing?
I'm doing okay, yeah. I saw you listing this, and wow, that sounds wonderful.
Yeah, it's a nice place. We do backyard wrestling. There's like a wrestling ring in the backyard with bleachers.
Oh, no kidding.
So we actually give you a small discount on the rent if you join the wrestling games.
I don't know if I'm equipped on that.
Yeah, no. Like, anyone can do it. Like, everyone in the neighborhood joins in. Like, if you think you can't fight certain people, we'll put you in the ring with, like, an 11-year-old. You can beat
them. Well, maybe an 11-year-old, that might be an issue.
Yeah. You can beat the shit out of an 11-year-old, and they can't even do anything because it's in the ring.
So cute. Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is. There's a lot of people coming in and out all the time, though. They'll be coming in to use your bathroom and, you know, getting snacks out of the kitchen, like the audience members and the bleachers and the wrestlers.
Really?
And, yep.
It would just be myself and my stepdad.
Okay, yeah, that sounds great.
Yeah.
How's your stepdad at the old 1-2 punch thing?
I don't know. He's an older man. He's 72.
Oh yeah, we have lots of older people. Yeah, lots of injuries around
here.
Oh,
he was a Marine, so him son, he can do something.
Yeah, great. Great. Do you guys have any pets?
I was thinking I have a cat. I don't know if that would bother you.
Oh, no, it's fine with us. It's just like we have a lot of dogs locked up in the backyard in cages because we do dog fights.
Oh, you
in the
do?
Ring. Yeah, dog fights in the ring. That's only a weekend thing, though.
Oh, that's going to make me very upset. You don't let them kill each other, do you?
You know, sometimes things get a little crazy, but for the most part, no, they just hurt each other real bad. So you want to keep the cat...
That's awful.
You want to keep the cat...
I have to make sure I don't see any of that.
Yeah, you want to go somewhere and, like, go hang out in downtown or something on the weekends.
Okay.
Stay away.
Where is your house?
Take your damn cat with you. We're over on Bates Street.
I'm not really familiar with New Bedford too well, so I'm not exactly sure where that is.
Oh, yeah, it's, it's right in the middle, right, like, north part of town.
Oh, on the north end, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, real close to the lake.
Oh, nice, okay. I know where that is.
Okay. Nice. Yep.
All right,
have you ever
come and see?
Well, yeah, anytime you want to come by, we're here a lot. We live just a block away. How are you on the trapeze?
Oh, I'm not. I would never do that. I'm afraid of height, unfortunately.
Yeah, but if you fall, you just land in the middle of the wrestling ring.
No, I don't think I can do that.
Yeah, but it's...
I would wrestle. That I would get in play and have fun and do that with you, but I don't know about any trapeze.
It's a professional wrestling ring. You'll just bounce right off of it and fall in the yard if you fall.
Well, we'll have to see as we go along. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yep. Okay. Do you know any country songs?
No.
What kind of music do you listen to?
I usually listen to, like, the older music that I grew up with, Elton John, classic rock, stuff like that.
Elton John, then. Okay, can you sing some Elton John for us real quick?
Oh, my God. I'm not a singer. Are you ready?
Yep, I'm ready.
Benny in the Jazz. Benny.
Keep going.
and this time the interview. let me think. I'll sing Leave On. How about that? Leave On makes his money, makes what they say. He spends his days counting in a garret by the moon.
that was great.
That's the best I got.
That was perfect. It was great. I loved it.
You're a lot of fun. Why are you asking me all this? This is so funny.
I don't know. I just like music, you know, and my Spotify got shut off. I couldn't afford it.
Well, you certainly didn't want to hear me sing.
Oh, no. I love Elton John and that other person that you sang.
So what's going on? So it will come fully furnished if I wanted it to?
Oh, yeah, definitely fully furnished. It's just that a lot of the furniture is broken. Did the ad mention the poltergeist?
No.
Yeah, there's a small issue with ghosts and poltergeists inside the house.
Okay.
So it pretty much breaks all the furniture and any pictures that are on the wall and mirrors.
Really?
You have to be careful, like, if you have mirrors, like, especially if it's floor-to-ceiling, because sometimes you can accidentally walk through it and, you know, into another dimension or something. It's because of the poltergeist activity and ghost stuff.
Really?
And the ghosts are very perverted.
Well, you can't be saying that to my stepdad, because he will never, ever move in, ever.
Oh, well, as long as he stays in the upstairs bedroom and never leaves, like, the ghosts don't go in there at all. Because that room was, it was taken care of by a priest.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just made the activity in the rest of the house much, much worse.
Well, have you tried any clearance?
They won't come to the house anymore, not since the incident.
What happened?
I can't talk about it.
Okay.
But this thing pick up your cat and just like fly it across the house. It's a mess.
Really?
Yeah.
So is that why you don't live there?
Yeah, we used to live here, but we couldn't. You know, we just it's hard to live here. You don't get any sleep. There's like this voice all the time screaming Carol Ann or whatever.
Are you serious?
I really am. I'm sorry. And it's a
You're giving me a hard time.
No, I'm not giving you a hard time. It's also a transgendered ghost. So,
okay.
Like, you don't have a problem with that, do you?
No, I don't care about transgendered. I actually have a friend of mine who's transgendered, so I've never dealt with a ghost, though.
Yeah. This one, we've had a few people actually die because it's, like, thrown people off the balcony and stuff.
Well, I'm not prepared to die yet. How much is the rent again?
950.
To go and die.
Well, you're not necessarily going to die. That's why the trapeze stuff is a good idea. You know, get yourself limber and ready to, like, grab onto things as you fall over.
Well, you know, you've given me a lot of food for thought, and I don't know. I was interested in looking, but now you're making me a little nervous, I have to be honest.
Yeah, it's you know, it's a different living situation. It's definitely different.
Mhm. All right. Well, I'm probably gonna come and look at it anyway and get a feel for it and feel okay. What the house feels like.
Great. Yeah, and, sounds great.
See what's going on with you guys.
Did I tell you about the pit in the living room? Like, there's a large hole in the floor.
You sound like you don't want me to rent it.
No, it's not that. I'm just like it's full disclosure. Yeah. I gotta let you know everything.
There's a big hole in the living room floor?
Yeah, well, it's a pit. Like, we're digging tunnels underneath the floors. And it's about a 60-foot drop down into the earth.
And, like, okay, is it wide open where I couldn't have a living room?
Pretty much.
Fall into a pit?
Yeah, yeah. There's a we just have a beam across it, so you'd have, it's like a balance beam. You just have to walk across it and be really careful not to fall in.
But yeah, I don't think this is ever going to work out, but yeah. I feel like you're pulling my leg a lot.
Oh, no, I wouldn't pull your leg. That's the poltergeist job.
Okay.
But,
all right.
But, like, you know, it's just like to get from the front door into the kitchen and the bedrooms, you have to go across this beam.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
Oh, come on.
It's really not. It's not going to work for me.
It's a little bit of adventure in your life, that's all.
Yeah, no, I can't. I actually use a cane for the most part.
Oh, that's good. The cane will help you. It's like extra balance, you know, like when you're walking across.
Not on a beam. Thank you, though.
Oh,
thanks.
You're welcome.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you so much for singing those songs to me.
Sure. Okay.
I really appreciate it.
Well, I'm a good-natured person, so.
I can tell. I wish you'd reconsider. If you reconsider, be sure to call us back.
All right. Well, thanks.
Okay, bye.
Bye. All right. Come on, Mike. Are you awake? You gotta listen to this story. You're not even gonna believe your own ears. How do you pause this?
Holy shit.
That's how you pause it. Alright, listen to me. The $950 a month furnished house in New Bedford. I just got off the phone with the guy. Right. There's a big west wing pit in the backyard, and you have to be comfortable with people coming in and out of your house to use the bathroom and stuff. I said, well, I don't know about that. So I want to wrestle everybody in the neighborhood wrestles. I said, well, no, I don't. I'm disabled. I said, I'm moving in with me and my stepfather. They do dog fights. Well, I'm horrified about that. I said, I'll definitely not be there. Dogs in cages in the backyard. Poltergeist in the house. I said, now you're pulling my leg. You really are pulling my leg. No. I said, well, you couldn't tell my stepfather that. He'd be petrified and never move in. I don't know. He said, well, if he stays in the upstairs bedroom and never leaves it, he'll be fine. Otherwise, you know. I said, well, have you ever had the house cleared? Well, they won't come anymore since the last incident. I said, well, what was the incident? Well, I can't talk about it. I said, okay.
okay. I said, you know, prior to that, he asked me if I have ever done the trapeze. I said, oh, no, I'm petrified of height. I would never do that. I said, I might get involved in the wrestling if I was in the ring with 11-year-olds. I said, but trapeze has never happened.
Yeah.
Then he says,
there's what?
Oh, there's a pit in the middle of the living room. I said, what do you mean there's a pit in the middle of the living room? We're digging tunnels. Oh, I said, well, now let me ask you this. I said, is this covered over or is this wide open? Well, it's not wide open. There's, you know, water across the year. You know, it's like a balance beam. That's why. And he tells me the poltergeist will throw you around and tip it over. And I still really pulling my leg. I said, well, thank you so much. But the open tent in the living room, I really can't go any further. I said, I walk with a cane most of the time. I said, well, that's good. That's the balance. I said, you really pulling my leg. He said, no, that's the poltergeist job. I said, you don't want me to rent this apartment now, do you? I said, then he says that the poltergeist has killed people. I said, and how much for rent? He said, $950. I said, and you want me to go live here and pay you $950 to get killed? I really thank you for your time. You've made me laugh. This has been very entertaining. I said, I don't know. That is conversation from that apartment on Craigslist. $950 a month. Fully furnished in New Bedford.
Where are my bills?
Fucking pit in the middle of the living room with beams across, but you got to walk to the kitchen from the front door around the balance beam. And people in and around the house, and dog fights in the backyard. And, you know, it's a different type of living situation. That's a fucking crack house.
That's a life, different lifestyle that we're used to.
Oh, man. The only one who calls me back. I can't make up shit like this. This has been my whole life. Shit exactly like this. Here I are, falling apart. Pissed in the living room, trapped a professional wrestling ring in the backyard. Trapeze. What's my favorite music? Can I sing Elton John to him?
What was the story with the trapeze?
Oh, I don't know.
That was great! See, this is what I always say. My pranks give people an awesome story to tell their friends and their families. But she actually sounded sad around the end of the call. But then she runs upstairs or whatever to tell her dad the story, and they have an awesome laugh together. Basically, I brought them closer together, gave them something to bond over. She's going to be telling that story like for the rest of her life, probably. I was actually starting to feel bad about around the end of it, because she sounded kind of defeated. But then she, like, you know, she starts talking about me, like saying it was like a crack house and being kind of a jerk about it. Jeez. No, I'm not going to call her back. That was fun, though. Like, how often do we get to hear people stay on the phone and tell the story? It's kind of like a calls of mass confusion thing. Getting to hear someone recap the call after we've made it. Thanks, chat room, for all of the ideas. Those were some good ideas. That's why I did this live. I didn't know what to say to these people that wanted to rent an apartment. I think I mentioned it before, but the Craigslist ad has been taken down. But I still have a bunch of numbers in the list still that I have not been able to reach, and like a bunch that I haven't called, and then a bunch that have texted me. So maybe I'll do another show of these. I don't know. Anyway, bye, everyone.
Hey, Mr. Dabalina.
Hey there, Tourette TV.
I was wondering, hey, it's Tourette TV, by the way.
Oh, you don't say.
I was wondering, how high can you turn your mic up? And also, being left on speakerphone. So I hope it sounds as great as your really loud ass mic.
It sounds better.
How high can you turn that shit up? I want to hear it.
Okay, this is as high as it goes. And I could turn it up even higher, but I don't want to because then the knobs will be all messed up. And I'll have to fix them. I'll have to figure out where they go. That's always a big pain in the ass when that happens by accident. You're just trying to get me to fuck up all of my shit. Cut it out.
What's up, Brad?
Hey.
It's Casper in Chicago.
Oh, hey,
Give
Casper.
Give me a call to say hello. I hope you enjoy your cameras. And,
of course I will.
Tool set thing for taking things apart and breaking.
Casper sent me, like, this tool set thing. It was on my wish list on Amazon. I've been meaning to buy it for myself, and he just sent it to me, and I've already used it. I used it tonight, in fact, to take apart one of the answering machines because it still had its speaker hooked up, and people kept dialing into it, and I kept hearing touch tones, and there was no way to turn the volume down. So I opened it up and clipped the wire for the speaker. I don't need that waking me up in the middle of the night.
I hope you got that book, too, the thing from Alton, Illinois.
Oh, you sent that.
I think it's where you're from.
Yeah.
Anyway,
Thanks,
still broadcast
Casper.
Your show here up in Chicago. I'm trying to get fucking Hillock to come up to the north side and do a show here live and broadcast it out over the air live.
That'd be crazy.
I don't know if my signal reaches downtown. I'm all the way up, it doesn't matter where I'm at. But anyway, I just pretty much randomly broadcast different shows of yours. I chop them up a little bit. I cut all the voicemails out because I hate the voicemails.
Casper's a pirate, everyone. He does shady pirate stuff.
And as I said many times,
broadcast my shows over the air.
Before, I cannot stand the way cell phones sound. They sound like shit. Shit, I say shit!
Are you
anyway,
on a cell phone?
I hope
fine.
You're doing good. And I love listening to your show, and I know a lot of my listeners do as well. So, that's it. Go fuck yourself. Bye.
Hey, this isn't the dick show. What the hell? Yeah, Casper sent me a book, too. It's basically a book of pictures, photographs, and stories behind Alton, Illinois. And it's written by some guy I went to high school with. That's the only reason I was planning on buying it. But now I don't have to, because Casper sent it to me. Thanks, Casper.
It's Earth and Claire's kids.
Yeah?
Hey, Roy, okay. Your show's whack.
My show's what?
Yeah. They're really good. I give you...
Oh, they rock. Oh, thanks, Earl Sinclair's kid. Tell your father he's a horrible person for letting you listen to my shows.
Hi, Brad.
Hey.
Or Roy, or whatever you want to call.
I don't give a shit.
It's always something different. Anyways, I just listened to the other Snowplow show, and you say that my know who I am because my number's unknown. Well, let me introduce myself. Hi, my name is Dal.
Hello.
I'm a great guy.
How do you spell it?
You know, I'm single, so, you know, if you want to mingle, you
Dal?
Know. You know, I'm down. But,
D-A-L?
Yeah, I can't get involved with everything.
D-E-L?
You know, with the actual PLA and all that.
Dal the funky homosexual? Can I put that in here?
Stuff, because, you know, I don't have a computer right now. I just have a tablet and a phone.
Makes sense.
Because I broke my computer, because I dropped it on my foot.
That's a
but
bummer.
Anyways. I'm also the guy whose mom also watches the show. You know, I used to call in a lot, but then you didn't play the voicemail with my dad, which I got really triggered about.
I'm sorry.
So,
sorry.
Yeah, I kind of stopped calling in for a while. I thought you were mad at me. I thought you were going to delete all my voicemail.
Yeah,
but
I don't
not
know.
The case.
You know, I get voicemails sometimes, and they'll just be silence. It'll be like 23 seconds of silence, and I assume when that happens, the person is talking, but they've done something stupid, so I can't hear them. And then there's other voicemails that just sound like garbage, and I just don't play them because they sound really bad. You can barely understand them. So stuff like that happens sometimes. There's bad connections, and I just have to not play voicemails, so don't take it personally.
But, yes, this number that I'm currently calling from is Dal's number. You should always have me down as Dal.
How do you spell it?
A great guy.
Dal? D-A-L-E?
Well, I'll talk to you later.
I'm going
to
put it down as D-A-L-E right now.
That's kind of boring or stupid, but bye.
It's okay. I was talking over you anyway. And I'll just make it D-A-L. There. You're in my address book. I know who you are.
Yo, Brad.
Hey.
Flying, calling. Hey.
Hey.
Just had a quick question. Is the girl Stacy, is she the girl from the YouTube videos? Like, when I watch it on YouTube, like, you have them pictures going across. It's like a chick with, like, the Harley Davidson shirt. But
there's so many people in the shirt videos and the slideshow thing. I don't know. Probably.
And she has bangs. Like, dude, she's cute, man. Like, if that's your girl or whatever, man, like, I'm not trying to be a dick, but she's cute. She's funny too. Like,
I'll tell her you said so.
Another question
I
had.
No, we are not involved in any way. It's the first time I talked to her in like 4 years. She's just one of the many females in the PLA community that I'm not involved with.
Dude, do you ever worry about getting like caught or busted? Like,
for what?
Just some asshole being like, oh, this motherfucker.
You mean the FBI coming to my door?
From here, and he does this and does that.
That'll never happen.
That's something that was just on my mind. Anyway, man, get back to me.
Okay.
I'll play my shit. You usually do. All right, peace out, man. Later.
All right, bye. Yeah, I'm not doing anything illegal. I'm just making silly calls to people, giving them hilarious stories to tell their father-in-laws.
Greetings, Brad. It's Mr. Tornado Head.
Hey, Mr. Tornado Head.
Hey, I just wanted to compliment you on Friday's live show. That was fucking hilarious. That lady at the end who thought she hung up the phone. Oh, classic.
Yep, she was fun.
Solid work, man. And do more live shows, hobo.
All right.
Cactus cat.
I will.
Hey, Arby.
Hey.
Jack from Alaska.
Hello.
Anyways, I just was wondering, like, how much did you pad that now reaching, like, 500 and some shows number? I mean, dude, the numbers just don't add up. 500 shows? I mean, are you counting all those phone shows? Are you counting all the Phone Losers of America shows? Are you counting Vito's and all those fuckers shows? Or, you know, I just think you should come clean and just tell us, like, realistically, how many Snowplow shows are there?
Just listen.
I'm ballparking 190, 200 maybe?
Yeah, right.
But almost five? I mean, dude.
I've been doing this since, what, 2014? Shows a week?
Fucking get with it.
Oh, okay.
It's out, man.
Whatever. But, yeah, if I do two shows a week, that's 104 shows per year. Times 4 years, yep, we're approaching 500 shows. I'm looking in the PLA media pack. It looks like I officially started this version of the Snowplow show. The first three episodes were video shows, so they're a little bit different. But the first show that I decided to call the Snowplow Show was May 28th, 2013. Holy shit, I just passed my 5-year anniversary. So basically, I'm slacking off. I haven't done two shows a week. Because if I had, I'd be over 500 shows right now. I'm only up to 472. I'm a big slacker. Pad the numbers, whatever.
Hey, Brad, it's Nico.
Hey,
I was just calling because the coolest thing ever just happened. Mm-hmm. There's a vote in Ontario. And I had my voter card, and then you need one piece of additional ID. And I got to use my PLA card for the first time. They actually took it. Like, they were like, oh, yeah, that's what it says on here. And then they let me vote, even though
I made you a fake ID with your real name.
On my card, Nico Nicole. Anyways, I just thought that was hilarious, and, like, my mind is blown. Anyways, wanted to share that with you.
Hilarious.
We'll talk to you later. Bye.
Gives me a lot of faith in the Canadian government that they'll take a PLA ID card that I laminated myself.
Brad.
Hello.
Oh, I was going to phone up to ask you, how far have you got in Sonic Mania? Have you completed that game yet?
Sonic Mania?
And,
no.
I was going to ask, the
I've never played that.
Played Sonic Mania, because it's a really, really good game. I'm just by the Lava Reef zone, which is it's like a remake of different zones from the Sonic game.
That's nice.
I'm sure Brad will love that game, Sonic Mania. It's a really good game.
I'm gonna stop doing the show right now and play a bunch of that.
He's not completed it yet. He has that's his homework tonight. Is he's got to complete Sonic Mania.
All right, it's gonna be a long night for me.
Bye.
Yeah, come on. You know the only thing I ever play is GTA 5. Probably the only thing I'll ever play again. So the show's over, everyone. Thank you to the sponsors, Todd L, B.I. Eber for life, Brandon R, Kirstie T, Matt Z. I will think lovingly of all five of you as I post this show. Probably not till tomorrow, because it's getting kind of late now. And besides, I have to play Sonic, right? I have to stay up all night playing Sonic. Please support the show at patreon.com/phonelosers. That keeps the shows happening. If you support the show enough, maybe I'll actually do 2 shows a week more consistently, so listeners can accuse me of padding the show and making up numbers. I'm looking at the dates on 2013, and there's quite a few gaps in there. You know, I would skip a week every once in a while. That's before I started the Patreon, isn't it? Didn't I start the Patreon in 2014? Back in 2013, I was always like, don't send me money. It's weird. I don't like it. And now I'm begging for money in every single show. What have I become? Yeah, here's a 1 week gap. Here's a 2 week gap. You know, I do the secret shows, the Hobosodes, and I've done 109 episodes of those. Those are the shows that only the supporters can hear. So if I had just called those Snowplow shows, but made them unavailable, I could claim that I've done, 472 now, plus 109, so 581 shows I've done. But I can't make that claim. That would be padding my numbers. And I can't count the 17 episodes of Mr. Dabalina's Wonderful World of Prank Calls I've done. I don't want to pad my numbers. Or the 12 episodes of Brad's Cactus Shack, or those 4 episodes of the PLA show thing, the call-in show. I should just call every show I do the Snowplow Show. Put them all together as one. That way I'll have like 1 billion shows done by next year. Today I'm ending the show with a Bone Cage song called Charlie Loves You. But it's not by Bone Cage. This is a cover by Eric B.
Hey Sue, I'm Charlie. I couldn't help but see you sitting here alone. Hey Sue, can I call you?
Like who wants to get a place that's currently on fire?